What was your favorite memory from when you were a student at school? Now, this could be any grade, any age, as you were a student. I'll go first. My favorite memory as a student was when I was in college. I got to go to Italy and I got to sing for Pope Frankie, which was a really great experience. We spent 9 days in Italy just pilgrimaging around, which was really cool. It was a really great spiritual experience for me. And Mr. Baker.
I got to go to my very first field trip to Second City, and that changed a lot about my life. But the biggest change was my homecoming dance where I met my wife. We went to homecoming together. Oh.
Mrs. Baker.
I'm going to say in elementary school, field day was my most memorable. And I'm also going to clarify that we did not meet at homecoming. We met before homecoming.
I know that. I was trying to simplify things.
Thank you. Mrs. Beckett.
I got to go to Spain my sophomore year, and so that was really memorable for me. And then during my senior year, I had no idea what I wanted to do or be. And for some reason, I was down in the elementary school, and I was watching Mrs. Nelson's class release for the day, and one little kid ran out and then said, "Oh, I forgot my hug." And then he ran back, and she gave him the most like heartfelt hug, and I thought, that's it, that's what I want to do. So that stuck with me always.
Mr. Beckett.
I graduated from Seeger, so I think the most memorable time I had, my senior year, we had the first undefeated football season in school history. So that was probably the one that stood out most.
Mrs. Beyer.
I went to school in Illinois, and I guess my favorite memory would probably be my senior year. We had a really strong tennis team. My doubles partner and I went to the state tournament in Illinois, and girls tennis was in the fall. We played in the sleet, in the rain, lost, but it was a lot of fun. And then a tradition my high school had was an all-night party after graduation to keep their students safe, and it was a lot of fun. Bowling, movies, food, dancing, prize, door prizes. It's kind of like after prom, but it was after graduation. Those would have to be my two favorite memories.
Mr. Broadwater.
Senior skip day. Was a really big thing in our school. And the year I was a senior, our administration decided they were gonna put an end to it. And so on skip day, the state police showed up where we were all at with school buses and brought us all back to school. And that was the funniest thing ever. So I still remember that.
That's awesome. Miss Campbell.
We had something called mini courses. And as a teacher, somebody put a lot of work into this, but I didn't realize that as a high school student. But we were allowed to choose a field trip. There were all different choices. And so one year we toured historic homes in Indianapolis. And another year it was another downtown trip. So that was really impressive. Now that I'm a teacher, I really enjoyed those things.
Mr. Collins.
All the field trips in junior or elementary school that we got to take, like to the Brookfield Zoo, some things like that, Chicago, you know, the place I'd never been. So those were good. And then senior night basketball, my senior year, I was named player of the game and got carried off the court by my teammates. So
it was awesome. It was awesome. He shut down the best player on the other team.
Mr. Comer, happy birthday.
Thank you, everyone. Gone to Pine Village for 11 years. My senior year, we consolidated with Williamsport and Seeger, Pine Village. So that was a different experience, a lot more people. We weren't supposed to like it, but we all did. And here I am still at Seeger. Then the other thing I remember is this one teacher, math teacher, who told me I should consider going to college, which I wasn't going to do, but I remember that.
Mr. Commons.
The sixth grade trip to the Museum of Science and Industry and then playing for Mr. Peter.
Thanks. Mrs. Conrad.
When I was a senior, we got to go to tennis regionals. My partner couldn't play with me. I played double, so I had to play with a JV player. We still ended up winning, so that was a really fun time.
Miss Crowder.
I think my favorite memory of high school was probably winning state by marching band, which was just an amazing experience. And then the other best memory I have is probably when I went to Haiti in college and I had the chance to develop some curriculum for the ag teachers in Haiti. So that was really cool.
Mrs. Davis.
loved every basketball season, 7th grade through 12th. We lost our 12th grade sectional by 1 point, and my can confirm that my dad will still tell me to go practice my free throws. That contributed to our senior loss, but just any basketball season was really fun.
Mrs. Kronk.
Every Saturday morning, any invitationals or doubleheaders for softball, just getting up early, seeing what parents brought, what good snacks for breakfast, and just spending the whole day with my team. Those are, you know, what I miss the most, I guess.
Mr. Davis.
We would eat lunch as fast as we possibly could and then sprint to the gym and play ping pong every day.
Mr. Foxworthy.
I went to Singer. It's my sophomore year. We won baseball sectional, and that was the first sectional they'd won since we consolidated. And my dad and uncle were on the Seeger Indians that won the sectional, so they were there. We got quite a few people of it.
Mr. Green.
When I was at Harrison as a sophomore, the football team won a sectional, and it was the first year that they were 5A before there was the 6A superclass. And so we won our little like Lafayette sectional. I think we beat Jeff. We went to Fort Wayne and played, I think it was Fort Wayne Snyder, for the regional championship, and we got blasted the whole first half. It was like 50 or 60 something to nothing. And I can remember walking through, you had to go through their stands. There was like a tunnel. And I just remember this one kid like leaning way out, just like, "Welcome to 5A!" While we were going into the locker room at halftime. And while it was kind of sad when I look back on it, like it was really funny. It was like a totally funny thing to shout at some kids. We were just like wide-eyed country kids coming into the big town and just got obliterated. It was fun.
Miss Green.
Well, my senior year, I was able to go to Mexico and England and Alaska all in the same summer. It's not like my favorite memory, but so when I took speech class after my brother and my sister, and as you guys probably know, Mr. Green is really good at speech. My speech teacher was like, "I'm so excited to have you." And I was like, "Nope, I'm not going to be that good." So my first speech was a how-to, and it was how to wrap a present. It looked horrible. And so at the very end, I just cleared the whole entire table, and I was like, "And this is how to not wrap a present." And I'm pretty sure it's because Brian was my brother that I got an A in that class.
Mrs. Grimmett.
We were playing basketball, and I played for Lowell Rademacher. And we had the invitational, and we ended up, we couldn't get the ball in, you know, into the big people. So he had me, I was a shooting guard, but he had me dribble the ball down, and he said, "Just go to the top of the key and shoot it so we can get the rebound." Well, that was before the 3 points. It was just 2 points, but I five times in a row, and they swished every time. So I was the top, you know, scorer that day. But we ended up going into overtime and beating West Lafayette. So that was pretty fun. Also with Lowell, if you were on the bench and he got mad, you got hit with his coat. He would take his jacket off and throw it at you or throw it at the bench. And also in the eighth grade year, we were the first class in the junior high hall, and they had carpet and everything. So my dad was always the gum man at church. So we had gum all the time, and you weren't supposed to chew gum. So I learned a little saying, the gum chewing student and the cud chewing cow. They look quite alike, but they were different somehow. What is the difference? I see it all now. It's the intelligent look on the face of the cow. Yes, I had to write that quite a bit in eighth grade.
Writing sentences were horrible. CH.
I went to school in Illinois also, and when I was in seventh grade, they had a state tournament for junior high sports. So I qualified in the shot put for the very first Illinois Elementary state track meet ever. And I can remember riding in the car with my mom and dad because they didn't supply a bus for us. And my dad saying, "It doesn't matter how well you do, you're making history right now." And I will never forget that and how proud he was of me.
Mrs. Hunter.
This is a really hard one. I never ever thought I was gonna be a teacher. Growing up, I didn't have that moment where like, this was like this call or this inspiration. But looking back, I loved absolutely every single thing about school, like from getting the new school supplies to starting off the year and meeting your teachers on the first day of school. And the football games and the basketball games and the marching band, like all of it. And I look back and I think, you know, I hate that our seniors are missing out on this last couple months, But it's all those little things and those moments together with your friends that just made it so special. So focus on the good, right? It's all of these great relationships that we get to build.
Mrs. Holland.
When I was a freshman playing mostly JV basketball, Coach Paul let me dress varsity a few times. And there was a game against Terre Haute South where I had Steph White to my left and Kelly Fink to my right, who were the two seniors. And they both, and he called me in and they both kind of like smacked my thigh and were like, let's go get them. And I could, that, I don't remember the game. I remember the two seniors paying attention to a freshman. I mean, I could still like wet my pants over how amazing that was. Then I remember a cute boy my junior year asking me to prom, and then a few years later asking me to marry him. So that was always, that kind of capped off high school.
Mrs. Kirkpatrick.
I went to Fountain Central. We had this super intimidating English teacher. I mean, I still kind of am nervous, just the idea of seeing her. She was a great teacher. And a whole group of us as seniors, we were in the honors English class. She had this camel-like concrete statue in her yard in Hillsboro. And we stole it on Halloween. And we had this whole thing where we like held it for ransom for us all to get A's in senior English. We had it blindfolded on the railroad tracks. We had it hanging over the overpass. But we had to go get these pictures developed. This was in the 90s. So there's this whole like, but all of us were like collaborating, and we thought it was hilarious. We were cutting out, you know, the letters and newspapers. We just thought we were the funniest. It was so funny because she had this great sense of humor that we'd never seen. She played it up. She thought it was awesome. But our whole little group, we came together during that, and that was amazing. My other favorite was actually, we went to St. Petersburg, Russia. There, many of the same kids. We did an exchange program, and that was this amazing, incredible experience.
Mr. King.
Well, other than winning a state championship when I was a senior, we got snowed in school. I know you can see it up there. I stuck the sign up there, so I have a sign for it in my back room. We got snowed in. So the blizzard came and they wouldn't let us out of school in time. And so literally over 200 kids got snowed inside the school overnight. I wasn't so lucky. I ended up having to go home at 11:30. But when school ended, they released all the students to different areas of the building. And we had movies in the movie theater. I played basketball, swam, did all kinds of stuff. It was just it was like a huge party for about eight hours. And then everybody got out. Of course, we were out of school for like 3 weeks after that. So a very similar idea where school was just literally canceled. And that was a pretty cool thing.
Mrs. Laney.
Probably one of my favorite parts of high school was playing sports, being part of a team. I went to a little bit bigger of a high school, so track was one of my favorite things. We got to run at some really big meets against some really big schools. So I really enjoyed that. And maybe at the time I didn't enjoy playing some sports with my sister, but looking back, that was probably a nice experience.
Mrs. Lincecum.
I would definitely say all 4 years playing tennis at Seeger, and then my senior year winning sectionals.
Mrs. McBride.
I had to sign up for art my junior year to get my fine art credit for my degree. Yeah. And I'm still not artsy. But Mr. Gruber was the best teacher. I went in thinking that I was going to hate it. I was terrified, but he made art so much fun. And by the end of the year, I was in his room any chance I could get during my study hall, passing periods, whatever, talking to him and talking to the other kids. And I also went to Germany the summer between my junior and senior year. So that was really fun. And I also met my husband when I was a sophomore. So every prom, homecoming event, we were always together.
Mr. McMahon.
In high school, I used to sit outside Mrs. Laney's class and then just yell good morning at everybody. And it was the funniest thing ever because everyone always hates that. You know, they're like trying to dredge into class. I'm like, good morning. And I was annoying, but it was amazing. Then semester of college, I had a semester where I only had 2 days of classes, Tuesdays and Thursdays. So every single weekend was a 4-day weekend, which wasn't good for my grades, but that was still a good time. I really enjoyed that. And then prom came around my high school year, and it wasn't, so I won prom king, which was awesome. But the best part about it was my hair was the skater boy hair, and the prom crown didn't fit my head. So I still have those pictures, and I giggle at those all the time.
I will totally use that picture as my background if you send that to me for next week. Mr. Morgan.
Playing sports in high school, getting the chance to play against a couple of D1 basketball players that unfortunately chose to go to Purdue, DJ Bird and Travis Carroll. I'm getting to play them a couple of times throughout my senior year. It was a lot of fun. The other one would have been the camping trip that we got to take. It was a canoe trip and overnight camping trip sophomore year of high school. Those were some pretty fun times.
And Mr. Nickel.
I would say a couple of minor, obviously a lot of the FFA stuff was fun, but from a sports side of things, I love tennis, and I about quit my sophomore year because I couldn't make practices with State Fair, and Coach Webb actually met me out at the tennis courts at midnight, and we turned the lights on, played, and we actually got those practices to count, so that's always going to be a good memory of mine.
Mrs. Reynolds.
I remember in sixth grade, I went to Attica, and we went to state in football, and then turned around and went to state in basketball, so that was pretty cool. I got prom queen my junior year, completely unexpected, so that was a little emotional. But going to Attica, any rival games against Seeger were always the highlight, football, basketball, whatever it might be. So those are my best.
You can definitely tell there's like something in the air when we play Attica, and like it gets everyone pumped. Mrs. Rhodes.
One of my favorite memories was senior year. I had the opportunity to go to Spain for 10 days, and my mom was able to go, and some of my best friends and their parents were able to go too. So that was a really great trip.
Ms. Scott.
First off, all of you people who like leave the country in high school, I'm jealous. Farthest I've gone is Iowa. But I have two. One would be my first year in college getting to march color guard. I kind of went to the audition and said, I don't expect to get a spot. I just want to know what I'm doing. And then I ended up marching the whole season, which was fun and a little terrifying. And then in high school, we had three concert bands and two orchestras, one of which was just a plain old string orchestra. But my senior year, I was performing in all three concert bands and the orchestra on different instruments. And so I walked into the sight reading room at ISMA and saw the same sight reading judge four times, and they got a little suspicious. Any of my band memories?
Mrs. Smiley.
I love that so many people have mentioned international travel, because obviously I'm a fan of that. In college, my first international travel was study abroad to Vienna, Austria, and I ended up visiting, I believe, 13 different countries just during that one semester there. But in high school, I played soccer all 4 years, and our senior year, both the girls' team and the boys' team went to semi-state, and it was just so exciting supporting each other, and we were all friends with each other and doing so well in the tournament, and I loved it.
Mr. Cotton.
Aside from the athletics, playing in front of a crowd and stuff, that's always, you always remember that. I think being involved in a play was really fun, and then chasing after my mom's car after she dropped me off at school crying hysterically, that's also memorable. And all, one was in elementary and one was in high school, so you can think of that.
Mrs. St. John.
Some of my best memories in high school revolve around FFA trips to national convention in Louisville and state convention at Purdue, but really any trip that we would take as an FFA group or as an FFA officer team was always the best memories. And then also my junior year, my band and choir trip was to New York City, and so I'm not much of a traveler, but getting to go to New York and seeing all those iconic places was really, really special.
Mr. Stuckey.
Probably sports in general. Senior year, us winning state track meet as a school was pretty impressive. Making state for the first time in cross country as a junior was awesome, but probably my twin brother and I going out for diving our senior year. We were competitive with each other, but we just had a blast learning all sorts of new stuff, just trying to beat each other. So,
Mrs. Such.
So I did not play sports. I was in color guard, and I will say marching band trips are the best thing ever. I love them. Just getting on that football field, and I don't know, it's just really cool. And then I also did show choir, and my senior year, we went to Branson, Missouri, and I got to sing a solo on one of the big stages in Branson, which was just mind-blowing for me. It was awesome.
Mr. Turner.
On the sports side of it, one that stands out was my senior year running the high hurdles. The weather was perfect. There was no wind. Great competition at the sectional. I ran a 14-8 and got third in there and qualified for the regional. Didn't get out of the regional to the state. They didn't have Simmons State, but did well at the regional, but not good enough to get out. But that record stood in our small high school for 25 years before it got broke. The other one that stands out is I was part of a quartet in high school. It formed really funny though, because we all played instruments in the band and we all sang in the choir, but we all played different instruments in the band. So we were marching in it for football halftime, and it started to rain. Band and director got us off the field. We all went inside. We didn't have to go back out for the second half of the game. And so we got together with the music director and we started a quartet. And then that went on for a couple of years that the three guys were older than I was. So until they were seniors and graduated, we went around the county and Danville, Illinois and Vermilion County and different places and sang as a quartet. And then we put everybody together with our musical instruments and the quartet and others and put on muscular dystrophy shows 2 years back to back, raised money for muscular dystrophy, which was a lot of fun.
Mrs. Williams.
My favorite memory was probably when I was in the fifth grade, they took all of the kids in my elementary fifth grade class down to Bradford Woods, and we slept in cabins for 3 days, and we would go hiking and learn like a bunch of nature facts. Looking back now, I'm wondering why the teachers took that many fifth graders on an overnight 3 day trip, but it was awesome when I was a kid doing it. We had a lot of fun, learned a lot of fun camping songs. And it obviously was memorable for everyone because we were still singing those camping songs when we were seniors in high school going on field trips.
Mrs. Zener.
Definitely sports, of course. Playing basketball for Gary Hart and Tom Paulf and a few others and throwing shot put for CH. But 1991 at Seeger, we didn't have a class system yet. And we had Benton Central in our basketball sectional with Jan Connor, a Hall of Fame coach. And we could never get past them. And we beat them 47-36. And went on to regionals, and we were up 10 points with 2 minutes left and lost by a free throw with no time left on the clock. But anyway, had a lot of memorable times and got to go on and play a little Division III ball. So those were some good times.
Hey, you know what the best part of about being the guy who kind of leads this group around is there's no ramifications if you find the class of 2014 yearbook of Seeger, and you have the prom picture.
Let's go. It doesn't fit. You see it. Let's go.
I don't have to answer to anybody, Sean, to share that.
Yes. Yes. I was so handsome.
We'll have to take a poll on whether we're going to use that as backgrounds next week